Hi, welcome back to the Something to Think About series. This is Something to Think About for three options for how to grow your retirement accounts. Now, most people don't know there are three options, but we only had two for quite a while, and then the third one came on the scene maybe 20, 30 years ago and has done quite well. So let's take a look at the three options you have. One is up only, and that's kind of outdated. There was a time where our parents or grandparents could sell the family farm, put all the money in the bank, and literally make 8, 9%, 7% just from CDs. No risk, pretty safe. And they, you know, make enough money to survive. If you had, I know a million would be a lot back then, but if you had $1 million, you'd probably take a $70,000 or $80,000 income and be just fine. When that stopped working, number two, the most popular, came on the scene because number one's a bit outdated. The banks don't pay 8% for CDs, at least at the recording of this training. And what is that second option? Up and down. We call it the diversified portfolio or asset allocation. You know, it's your standard Edward Jones, Merrill Lynch, Morgan Stanley, your money manager, the person that kind of gambles for you 40-60 this way, 60-40 that way. It's spreading things around, hoping that over time, risk, you know, more risk is worth more reward, and it goes up. And that worked really well from 1970 to 1999 when the stock market went up, compounding at 13.78%. So today, this is still the most common place that I find people have their money. But we have a third option that popped on the scene a while back, and it's up and sideways only. There are no losses. This is the one where most money is transferring. We can always look and see where the money is moving. It was stocks in the 90s, real estate in the early 2000s, indexed products or products that have a floor and can't go down is where, for obvious reasons, most of the money is transferring as the baby boomers move from the growth stage of life, the accumulation stage, to where they've saved up the nest egg and now they need it to last forever. Well, if you need your money to last forever or you need income, then losses aren't quite as attractive. So just my opinion, if you like all the ups and downs, it's exciting for you. You like losing money and waiting 4 to 6 years to get back to the same place you've already arrived 4 to 6 years earlier. If you like recovery, then just use the number two strategy. Just use the market. All the ups and all the downs is going to be really fun for you because that's what happens. Money goes down, and then it takes 5, 6, 7 years to get back to where you already were. If you're taking income out during those down years, it could take you 10 or 15 years or possibly never to get back there. Well, if you take a look at this picture, and I understand it ends in 2015. I'm actually not using it as a modern look at which one would have beat the others. I can actually show you all the research that indexed products beat the market over every time frame we can measure. But it's a picture of how the green line moves, how the blue line moves, and how the red line moves. So that blue line would be like CDs or fixed annuities, you know, the up-only outdated strategy, which is only outdated because the interest rates aren't high enough to live on. Well, the red line, that's the most popular one. That's option number two, where I told you to just stick it out and stay there. If you like losing money and waiting 4, 5, 6 years to get that money back, you can see two drops right here that happened with. And the green line is the newest and the most popular these days for people who are close to retirement, or certainly if you are retired, not taking losses, giving up a little bit of the upside potential in some of the up years to never ever go backwards, never take a hit, never take a loss, never have any recovery years. You just start growing from that high watermark or that high point. That green line is an example of option number three when I'm teaching that there's three different ways to grow your retirement accounts. So if you'd like some or some, all your money to continually be protected from losses, you know, avoiding the 4 to 6 year recovery periods, then turn your attention to focusing on option three. It's fairly easy. You don't need to study option one. It doesn't pay enough. You don't need to have a broker or study option two anymore unless you like losses. Turn your attention to learning something new, which is what these trainings are for. There's a reason. Think about it. There's some reason that more money is transferring into number three than any of the other two options in today's economic environment. Now, some points just to kind of sum it up, some things to know about option number three, which is the up and sideways only, there are no losses ever. You know, on this short training, we can't show you how the companies protect you from losses, but suffice it to say, they never invest any of your principal in anything that can go down. There's a little bit of interest you're supposed to earn each year. They invest that for you and either lose it or make a bunch of money on it, but your principal is never invested. So in a down year, the worst news you're ever going to hear is you didn't make any money. It's like you got out of the market before the loss and sat in cash all year long. So you didn't make any money, but you avoided the loss. Good job going to cash. It's kind of like that. Now, second point, you get some of the gains, but not all of the gains. That can be measured, you know, by a percentage. If the market goes up 10, you get 70% of it. That's called a participation rate. It could be measured by a ceiling or a cap, which used to be high enough to use. Today, they're not really. It says you get the first 4% and nothing after that, something along those lines. Could be measured by a spread or a margin. The first 2 or 3% goes to someone else. But if the market went up 20 and the first 3 goes to someone else in a margin or spread strategy, you'd get 17. Picking something without a ceiling or with no caps seems to me, looking back over 2000 financial plans, seems to be the way to beat the stock market in safer products. Point number 3, many contracts have no fees at all. I get this question a lot. How can there be no fees? I go, I don't know. How much does the bank charge you to buy a CD? How much does the bank charge you to invest in any of their investments? And typically you find the bank's not charging anything for the CD because they're the ones that want you to give them the money. So I know we've all become used to fees, but for people that want your money, they don't have to charge a fee. They could just say, no, we want the money. So they eliminate the fees. So these contracts, a lot of them don't have any fees. So even in the down years, you're not taking a loss from fees either. We can eliminate that from the option 2, stocks, bonds, and mutual funds strategy. Now, you may choose to have a fee. There's some optional fees that do some kind of cool things. You know, I pay utilities in my home. I pay for food. I go out and pay for drinks. I pay for cars. I like to spend money making my life awesome. I don't mind fees at all, depending on where they're going. But in this case, if you choose to pay a fee, it doesn't go into your broker's pocket. It doesn't go to them playing golf all the time. It doesn't go to the advisor. The fee goes to either guaranteeing that you'll still have pension income even if you ran out of money. So if your account hit zero and you were taking $60,000 a year, you would still get the $60,000 a year from the investment company or the insurance company, and that's what the fee was for. You purchased something, guaranteed retirement income for life. Very cool. Or the fee could go to buying more of those amazing investments. If they're not using your principal, so there's no principal at risk and you can't lose it, but they're buying some amazing investments that might hit it big or we might lose all the money. So they're really kind of gambling with just your interest every year. If that's the case, some of us have said, well, can we give you more money and you buy more of those investments? And they said, hey, that's a good idea. And so today, there's some optional fees that you could choose inside of a investment with no risk of losses, a contract with no losses. You can say, I'd like to pay an extra fee and have more gains. And some of those contracts do fantastically well. Last point, they provide higher income for retirement. Oh, Charlie, what do you mean by that? Well, what do I mean by that? I mean, it used to be the 4% rule. If you had $1 million in stocks, bonds, and mutual funds, you could safely take $40,000 a year and have a pretty good chance of making it until your life expectancy while having income. That has been lowered to 2.8 or 2.9, but inside of these contracts, it often can be 5.5% or 6%. So it's not even at the 4%. It's higher than the market ever paid. So as it turns out, after reviewing over 2,000 financial plans in each and every case, staying with stocks, bonds, and mutual funds actually lowers your income, increases your risk of losing money, and subjects you to higher fees than necessary. Maybe that's why so much money is moving to the more updated retirement strategies represented by number 3. I'll bet your broker never told you that, but it's something to think about.